Assalamu alaikum. Giving a presentation requires a lot of skills, such as self-confidence and intensive knowledge of the subject that you are presenting or that you're talking about. Today, our students are going to give presentation about different topics. One of them, or the first one, is going to be Rida. So Rida, the mic is for you and you can start.
Welcome to my presentation, and today I'm going to talk about music. I'm going to talk about history of music, the connection between humans and music, and lastly, what is music. Without any further ado, let's get into it. So history of music. Music is one of the oldest things that have ever connected to humans since the prehistoric era. As we can see here, here is a photo of a flute that made out of cave bear's bones. Also, scientists found some old instruments in China, but are they the oldest though? The answer is no. The oldest musical instrument is the human voice itself. Scientists believe that they were using it for some religious hymns. Also, we can find the oldest musical traditions in India, in the Veda, which is the holy book of the Hindus. But music did improve with time, and we have the first ever stringed musical instrument, which is the Sumerian harp. And they were using it in temples for some religious rites. But have you noticed the connection between music and religion? Well, that is what take us to our next subject, which is the connection between music and the humans. Another great example for this will be the Catholic Church. The Catholic Church were using music to give the prayers some kind of a spiritual vibe. Also, music can be connected to something specific or some cultures. And it also can affect our health. Like this, for example, it's called music therapy. And yes, it is a real thing. It's a clinical use of music to accomplish individualized goals such as reducing stress, improving mood, and self-expression. Also, music can affect our feelings. And a great example for this will be the music from the movie Up. So Pixar Studios want to abbreviate their married life sense. So they did use the music to accompany this, and we will use this music for the example. Notice at the beginning how the music was so beautiful and so full of life. But after the wife passed away, the music turned into another different thing. Well, the music turned to be so blue, and that is just crazy. Because we didn't change the style, the only thing we changed is the pitch of the sound. Also, they only used the piano and harp at first to make us feel sad or blue. But it make us think, why do music make us feel that sad? I mean, why we feel sad when we hear sad music? It's just a couple of sounds with low pitch and high pitch. Well, that is what make us ask such an important question, which is, what is the music? So, music is a universal language of communication and is an art composed of sounds and silence across time periods. But with all the things we have talked about the music, I think one of the most important opinions about the music will be Dr. Fuad Zakaria in his book With the Music. He said about the music, it agrees with photography in a silent rhythm and it's subject to the same building rules that architecture is subject to. It borrows grace and the order lines of its steps from dance. It acquires a melody from poetry. In addition, it's inspired by the mystic gifts at one time and the feelings of the body at other times. In short, it appears as a major attempt to achieve unity in the human being, and that it reached depths in the soul that no other art knew or reached before. Thank you for listening.